एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ नियति चौहान, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट एलजी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एंड कंट्रोल. आवर सब्जेक्ट इज इंडस्ट्रियल डेटा कम्युनिकेशन एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड कंट्रोल सिस्टम, चैप्टर 2, डीसीएस बेसिक पैकेजेस एंड टॉपिक नेटवर्क्स एक्सेस प्रोटोकॉल एंड नेटवर्क टोपोलॉजीज. सो फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस how to communicate our components in highway compatibility. In last lecture, we have discussed about different protocol, right? One used most commonly for distributed control system, highway, is called high level data link control protocol. Other protocols used in distributed control system include binary synchronous communication, digital data communication message protocol and synchronous data link. So next we discuss how to send our data in message form. So first, opening flag. In opening flag, we send our data in form of 1010, right? And signals that a message is starting 8-bit, okay? So our message we are sending in 1010 form, right? Then address field. The destination of the message is 8-bit, right? So in here, we are sending our message, right? And our message is in digital form, okay? So first opening flag, then after address field. In address field, our message send in destination. Then control field. In control field, sequence message of frame 8 bits. So here we are see our message is in sequential form or not, okay? Then information field, the body, the message, any number of 8 bit, okay? So in next layer, that is information field. Then after security check. In security check, the correction of the transmission 16-bit. So here we are converting 8-bit message in 16-bit. Then after closing field, in closing field again we are converting our message in 8-bit. So how to communicate through message, here we are discussed about it. Next, network access protocols. There are a number of communication methods used for distributed control highway. First, a traffic detector may be detected placed on the highway to grant transmitting privileges based upon pulling the various stations on the highway or following a priority control sequence. So here in traffic detector, we check our message, I'm sending in sequencing or not, okay? Thereafter, second, a token is passed from station to station, granting it mastership. During the time it has the token, the station can communicate with any or all stations. So in second method, token is passing from station to station, right? And during the time it has the token, the station can communicate with any or all stations. When it has completed its transmitting task, which may not exceed a maximum time, typically it takes millisecond, okay, and it passes the token to the next station determined by a predetermined sequence. Some devices such as an operating stations require more time than other station and may be in highway priority station have nothing to say, okay? So here discussed about some devices such as an operating station require more time than other station and maybe in our high priority stations have nothing to say. So here we are sending token, right? Priority based, we are sending token. Third, carrier sends multiple access is used extensively in office management communication, but is also used for some distributed control system. Then number four, fourth method broadcast a shared memory from each station, making it available to every other station. The shared memory serves as an interface between the input circuitry of the station device and a highway controller device. Process input data is scanned and stored in shared memory. The data is taken from memory once a second and broadcast accessible to all station. Okay, so in fourth method, process input data is scanned and stored in shared memory. Okay, the data is taken from memory once a second and broadcast accessible to all station. Okay, if any other stations need information, its data highway controller listen for the data and places what it needs in its shared memory station. The station input section then takes the data from the shared memory when it needs to execute a control or output display information. In network access protocol, we are discussing here different protocols. So first, time division multiplex access, TDMA, and network type bus. Its advantage, simple structure, and disadvantage, not verify efficient for normal message. Traffic redundant bus, master required to maintain master clock. Second protocol, pooling. In pooling, we are using bus or ring protocol. Simple structure, more efficient than TDMA, and its disadvantage, redundant network, master required slow access to the network. Next protocol, token passing. So in token passing, network type bus or ring type, and its advantage, no master required can be used in large bus network topologies, and its disadvantage, must have a recovery strategies for drop token. Next protocol, carrier sends multiple access with collision detection, CSMA and CD. So it's network type bus type network, and its advantage, no master required, simple implementation, stable performance at high message traffic levels. And its disadvantage, efficiency decrease in long distance network access time to network is probabilistic and not deterministic. And last protocol, ring expansion. So in ring expansion, we are using ring network, and its advantage, no master required, supports multiple simulation message transmission. Okay, and its disadvantage, enable only on ring network. Okay, so here we are discussed about different protocols, right? First we have discussed some introduction of protocol. Okay, then after how to communicate in highway compatibility, then after we have discussed different protocols and its network type, its advantages and its disadvantages. In network topologies, instead of 8 separate cables, each run to an individual remote controller module. It is possible to communicate over a single pair of wires running from the operating station to all remote locations, one after the other. This is called data highway. So here we can say that in data highway, we are using one cable instead of 8 cables, right? And it's called data highway. And several operator stations can be connected to one highway. Some suppliers can interface programmable logic controller and data acquisition units to the data highway. Transferring information between this device and operator station. So here we are interface PLC and another data acquisition system, okay, and we are used for connection data highway. Thank you for watching video. If you have any query in this session, then you can ask me. And chapter 2 is completed, okay. In chapter 2, we have briefly discussed about how to communicate our devices, okay, and we have discussed high level operator interface, low level operators interface, local control units, okay.